Hello, welcome to my channel. In this video, we are going to be studying the behavior of electric charge inside the electric field. So the problem that we are going to be looking at in this video is giving us. So we have a small sphere of mass 1.5 gram and charge Q, a positive charge Q equal to 9.5 times 10 raised power minus 6 coulomb hangs by a thread between two charge plates. As shown in the figure below, calculate the potential difference between the plates that will make the charge deflect by an angle 30. So this diagram for the system. So we have two charged plates. So because it's a positive charge and because it is drawn towards this direction, it means this side is a negative charged plate and this side is a positive charged plate. And if we bring a positive charged plate and a negative charged plate together close, electric field will be established between them. So the electric field lines will go from this point to this point, from here to this point, right? So to solve this particular problem, we are to find the potential difference between these plates for this particular charge to be suspended at an angle of 30 degrees in this form. So to solve this problem, we have to look at the free body diagram for this system, which is giving us this. So there are several forces acting on this particular charged body, and one of the forces acting on this particular charged body is the tension T, which is giving us T. Then another force that is acting on this is the weight, which is giving us mg. Then another one acting in this direction, that is pulling it in this direction, is the electric force, which is giving us this electric force, right? So this tension can be resolved along this direction, which is giving us T cos 30. So this T can be resolved along this direction, which is giving us T cos 30. You can see that this is a T. This is the adjacent and hypotenuse. So if you resolve that, that gives us T cos 30. This same T can be resolved along this direction, which is giving us T sine 30. Now, as long as this system is in equilibrium, this force must balance this force. Likewise, this force must balance this force. But in electrostatics, there is a connection between this electric force and the electric field between these two plates, and also the potential between these two plates and the distance between them. And it's giving us this. So this is the electric field between these two plates is equal to the electric force all over the charge in the electric field vicinity. And is also equal to the potential difference between the two plates and the distance between them. So if we look at the forces along the x-axis, we can have it as T sine 30 must be equal to F subscript E. And we know that our FE, if you make FE the subject formula, it becomes E times Q, which is this. And since we are not interested in E, we are interested in the potential between this system, between these two charged plates, then we can replace our E, which is E, with V all over D. So wherever we see E, we replace with V all over D. So we have V all over D multiplied by this Q. So we are no longer interested in these two expressions. It is this equal to VQ all over D, since we are asked to look for the potential. Okay, so the forces along the vertical will be equal to T cos 30 equal to mg. This must be equal to this. Now, one way we can resolve or we can look for V is to combine this one and this with this and this. And the only way we can combine is to say this equation divided by this. Likewise, this divided by this. And we have T sine theta all over T cos theta equal to VQ all over D mg. And we can cancel this tension and that gives us tan 30 equal to VQ D mg. If you make your V the subject formula, you will have V equal to dmg tan 30 all over Q, where D is the distance between the two plates, M is the mass of the charged body. G is acceleration due to gravity. Tan 30 is the angle. So, and Q is the charge, which is 9.5 times 10 to the power minus 6. So if we substitute all these values, 1.5, into this equation, we'll get, but remember, when you are substituting the D, which is in centimeter, we have to convert to meters. The mass, we have to convert to kg. Then this will remain the same. And we have V equal to 1.5 times 10 to the power, this after converting to kg. This is a 9.8, which is the acceleration due to gravity. The distance, by the time you convert to meters, tan 30, all over the charge, which is 9.5 times 10 to the power. So if you use your calculator to solve this particular problem, you get V, which is equal to 74.45 volts. That's the voltage difference, the potential difference between the two plates, right? Thanks for watching. I hope you like. Please like, share, and follow. You can also subscribe to my YouTube channel, which is Babi's Lecture. Thank you.